Hi everyone, I'm Eric from Lonesome Reader. It is the Easter bank holiday weekend here in the UK. That means I have 4 whole days off to relax and read and enjoy myself, and I'm doing something very special. I'm going away with my boyfriend and 2 friends to a place called A House for Essex. This is a building which is under a group of buildings around the UK called Living Architecture. They're all really interesting, strange structures. You have to enter into a lottery to stay in these buildings because they have very limited capacity, and because they're so unique, they're in quite high demand. So I applied to the lottery to stay in A House for Essex, and I got a booking on this weekend, so it's very exciting. Only 4 people are allowed to stay in the house at one time, and it looks sort of like something between a cathedral and a big gingerbread house. It was designed by the artist Grayson Perry, who is a really eccentric, fascinating artist. He makes tapestries and ceramics, and he designed this whole house basically as a monument to this fictional character which he created called Julie. And the house is filled with artwork which is sort of memorializing Julie's life and which also tells the history of Essex. So it's going to be really exciting because the 4 of us are just staying in this house all weekend for 3 nights, all by ourselves, to explore it and enjoy it. And apparently all the artwork is alarmed, so I'm slightly concerned that we might accidentally set the alarms off, particularly if we've had a few drinks. But it should be a really fun time. We're just gonna relax and watch films and drink and eat a lot. Since it's the Easter weekend, of course we're gonna have chocolate eggs. I have these lovely Prestatt chocolate eggs. And of course, one of the most exciting things about a weekend away is planning what books I'm gonna bring and what books I'm gonna read while I'm away. I always find that I pack usually like 12 books and then only have time to read 1 or 2, because when I'm out with my boyfriend or friends, we're enjoying ourselves and having fun. I don't have as much time to read as I want to, but I'm hoping if I wake up early, I'll be able to get in some good reading time before we go on hikes or play board games or go to the pub or watch films. But I'm going to take you along and show you my reading progress as well as the amazing structure that we're going to be staying in. And this is the first time I've ever done a vlog, so I'm not really sure if I'm doing it right or if there's like a particular way I should be doing it, so I'm just going to sort of win it. But first, let's have a little look through my book collection of books that I've been wanting to read, and I'll pick out the ones that I'm going to take with me.
So here are some of the books that I've been wanting to read recently and that have been on my shelves for a while. As you can see, there's quite a lot, so it'll take me a while to decide what I want to take.
So I've had a good nose through my books, and I think I've been quite restrained. I've only picked out 8 books to bring with me, even though I know there's no way I'm going to read all of these. But I wanted to make sure I brought mainly only short books, because that'll give me more of a chance to actually hopefully finish 1 or 2. I've got First Love by Gwendolyn Riley. This is the last book I have to read on the Bailey's Prize shortlist. Ties by Domenico Starnone, because I think it just sounds like a really fascinating book about relationships. The End We Start From by Megan Hunter. This is set in London in like a post-apocalyptic environmental disaster type book. It's not out till May, but I heard her read from it. Sounds really interesting and heard great things about it. The Little Buddhist Monk by Cesar Aria, because he's a crazy writer. Octavio's Journey by Miguel Bonifoy, because it's about a kindly woman who teaches a boy to read, which I think sounds like a lovely story. Dear Friend, From My Life, I Write to You in Your Life by Yi Yun Lee, which is all about the reading life. I started this some time ago, and the writing is just beautiful. The Burning Ground by Adam O'Riordan. These are short stories which came out earlier this year and are very well regarded. And this slender little book of poetry called Stranger Baby by Emily Barry. I heard her give a reading from it, and the poems sound so strong, and Jen Campbell made a whole video dedicated to this book. So we'll see at the end of the weekend how many of these I get through, and now on with the journey.
What's the point in this? You do all the thinking, where are we? Just digging shelters in the snow. build a house, a dream, and I'm a gnome. I know it's falling down. Got my headphones on, I won't hear a sound. Know it's all broke down. Eyes out on the road.
Here I am at a house for Essex created by Grayson Perry, all as a memorial to his fictional character called Julie. And so it's set here on the Essex coastline in this beautiful countryside. And the only downside to it slightly is that there's a public footpath running around the house. So we get lots of people walking around the house trying to have a look in, but it's not like a museum that you can visit, and there's only four of us staying here. So it's sort of a strange self-conscious experience being in this absolutely beautiful house with all these people sort of walking around the outsides, peering in. It sort of makes us feel like celebrities in a weird way. So let me take you along and show you the house. It really has such a striking fairy tale like structure. Here we have the full outside of the house, and it's set in this countryside with not a lot around it except a lot of rapeseed flowers. And entering the house, you can see there's these magnificent clay tiles all around the house, some with Julie on them, and this egg sort of structure at the top of the house is a chimney. So going in, this is the foyer, where we've hung our coats up and stuff. It's very light and airy, and going in you can see those great green tiles are repeated in the kitchen and dining area, and there's this fantastic fireplace, which hopefully we'll have a fire later on. So we have lovely views outside. There's this toaster where you can see through while the toast is toasting. This is Julie's book collection. You can see there's a lot of feminist books, including Marilyn French and Iris Murdoch, Alice Walker, Margaret Atwood. So she obviously had very good taste in books. And going through this green tiled door, we come into the main cathedral part, which has these amazing tapestries. And these big ceramic jars. I really like the pattern on the floor. But it's a really big space, great for lazing around in. And this is Julie's CD collection. So there's a lot of John Denver and Elton John, Led Zeppelin. It really gives a sense of her growing up in a particular time and her musical tastes and how this reflects her particular ideology. So there's tapestries going up, and then this repeating wallpaper, which shows scenes from Julie's life. And then this is a ceramic statue of Julie herself. These are all scenes from different points in Julie's life, from her young adulthood to her childhood to her older age in her second marriage when she went to visit the Taj Mahal. And this is a tile floor memorializing Julie's death. This star-shaped gate here was put up at a later point when people who were rambling around on the paths outside kept climbing over to take selfies, so they had to put this gate in for privacy. There's a map of Essex on the tapestry, and it's fascinating looking through the different scenes on the tapestry, all these different points in Julie's life, including her death when she was apparently hit down by a takeaway delivery driver. This is Julie out with her work colleagues going to the pub. I really like this detail on the pub. And then there is a cat with the two towers and Elton John. These are different scenes from Julie's early life and her child, who looked like a miserable little sod. So this was meant to be the perfect marriage, the first marriage. But then Julie found a hairbrush belonging to another woman. I'm not sure what this in the corner represents. I'm not sure if she was supposed to have had a miscarriage or something. And then there's this vase, which also memorializes Julie's life. I think it's really lovely how Grayson Perry made this sort of as a way of giving dignity and importance to just an ordinary woman who grew up and lived in Essex. And these chairs are really comfy and nice. They look very like formal and throne-like. This is a great green-tiled sunken bath. I bet Julie would have loved to have had a long soak in this. I tried it out, and I don't usually like taking baths, but it was really lovely. This is the first of the upstairs bedrooms, where there's a large tapestry in front of the bed, which depicts her first marriage. And here in the second bedroom is her second marriage. Now I'll show you something quite cool. In each of the bedrooms, if you walk through to the closet area and you open these mirrored doors, there is a balcony out to the main hallway where you can see the motorbike and the tapestries. And this is Julie here. Hello, Julie.
Let your head hang long. Here old north wind is blowing through these cracked up walls, and you won't feel so strong. Voices on the street, yeah, it's closing time again.
So it's early Saturday morning, and I've woken up quite early. I just couldn't get back to sleep. I think I had a bit too much bourbon last night. It sort of affected my sleep, but I had a good time settling into this amazing new house. It's honestly so beautiful. We're just enjoying lounging around and soaking up the atmosphere and all the art that fills the building. Last night we read aloud to each other the poem that Grayson Perry wrote about Julie's life, which sort of inspired this house. And then we had some pizza and we played a game and we watched the film Smiley Face with Anna Faris. It's kind of a fun sort of stoner movie. And this morning I got up and I've started reading this novel called The End We Start From by Megan Hunter. It begins with a birth told in quite a shocking way, so it'll be interesting to see how this develops. Yeah, it's hard not to be distracted from the book when staying in a house this beautiful. I'm sort of enjoying just looking up at all the walls and all the tapestries. I think we'll be going for a long walk later today and getting some lunch and enjoying more of the atmosphere. There's a full moon rising, big and bright on the horizon. Are you feeling strange? A butterfly falling. Thought that would be so easy. Paid all the debts and now you're leaving. Closing your eyes, got your mama's eyes. Wouldn't tear our love apart.
does it feel when lights go up. So
it is Easter Sunday. I got up again this morning to do some reading while everybody else is still asleep. I seem to keep waking up really early. We had a lovely day yesterday where we got up and I made us blueberry pancakes and bacon. We went for a very long walk around the coast up to a place called Mistley, where we then sat and had a very long pub lunch and several drinks. And then we came back to the house to play some games and watch some movies, including the Steve Martin movie, The Man with Two Brains. It's quite a gray, cloudy day today, so I think we're going to be staying inside a lot more. It's interesting staying in the house for a couple days now and really getting a feel for the atmosphere of it. And I think Julie's story is having an effect on me. You know, like living in this house that's sort of like dedicated to her life. Like even though I know that she's a fictional character, you get this sense because you're living amongst her things. You see her books and her CDs and you like listen to her music and like look up at all these pictures of different parts of her life. And she does start to feel like a real person. And it's interesting that I've been still reading this novel, The End We Start From, which is very creepy and odd. Because the story starts with a woman giving birth at the same time as a sort of apocalypse happens when London becomes flooded and she and her husband have to flee and go stay with his parents. So it's about the start of the baby's life, but then the end of everybody else's as they know it. I've always felt it's interesting how we like to fantasize about these apocalyptic situations where, because I think we feel so out of control in how we can influence the rest of the world, that we like to fantasize that everything just ends and we can sort of start over and begin again and hope it's better the next time. But it's interesting too in this book how it shows the family unit, how, you know, really you're just this sort of like world unto yourselves. And so it almost seems strangely natural for the mother to just have this insulated life just with her baby. And Megan Hunter writes in an interesting way, just very short declarative statements interspersed with these Bible passages. I think if the world were to end, like this wouldn't be a bad place to get holed up in. So it's sort of interesting as we like get trickles of news about how the growing tension between China and North Korea, and there might be a nuclear war between them. And we sort of think that civilization can just unravel quite quickly. So when we've been talking to each other, we've been saying how it would be funny if we like, you know, got trapped in a house for Essex for, you know, the rest of our lives. Anyway, I'm enjoying this novel a lot, so I'm gonna go in where it's a bit warmer and read some more. Check white skirt. So it's Monday morning. It's our last day here at Essex House. It's gone very quickly. I'm sad to be going. It's a very brisk morning, but sunny, and the birds are singing, as you can probably hear. And I'm sat here on the back steps of the house. I'll show you the top of the house. And so I've been doing a bit of reading this morning. Woke up early as usual. Yesterday we went into a nearby town called Harwich and we had a Sunday roast and more drinks. And I could see how easy it would be to slip into this lifestyle of just having long, leisurely lunches with a few drinks with friends and then going home and watching some films and playing games. It was a bit rainy yesterday, so we went for a walk along some of the docks, but weren't able to spend that much time outside. And then we came back and we played a board game called Catan. And then we watched the film Welcome to the Dollhouse, which my friends had never seen. It's such a darkly humorous movie. And I finished reading Megan Hunter's novel, The End We Start From. And it is such an intense, beautiful look at our transforming familial lives, but then also the transforming society around us and where the clash between those two experiences meet. I've also been reading Cesar Arias, The Little Buddhist Monk, and his writing style is just sort of oddball. It'll be sort of slightly philosophical and then quite like whimsical. It's about a French couple who are photographers that meet this physically little Buddhist monk in Korea. And this monk sees an opportunity to escape the confines of his own sort of small existence. In this country, he has aspirations to live elsewhere in the world and be something much bigger in his life. But Cesar Arias also reflects a lot about language and art. I've also been reading more of Emily Berry's poems called Stranger Baby, and I was particularly struck by this one poem called Two Rooms, because upstairs there are two bedrooms, and one bedroom is about Julie's first marriage, and the second bedroom is about Julie's second marriage. And Emily Berry has this poem called Two Rooms. It's very short, and she writes, "I went into one room, and then I went into another. I was in a room, inside a room. There, I felt safe." And of course, this isn't about two physical rooms, but about a room inside of a room, or the way we shelter one part of ourselves inside another part of ourselves. The way we contain different parts of ourselves more deeply inside, and other parts of ourselves we show to the world more readily. So I've had a wonderful time here. You can see now that the sun has come out really strongly. I feel really lucky to have had this experience. And I think it takes staying in the house to really experience this artwork that Grayson Perry made, to understand the life of this character called Julie that he created, who's just a typical Essex woman with dreams and aspirations and who experienced disappointments, but also lots of joy along the way. And her life is reflected colorfully throughout the entire house. So I hope you've enjoyed coming along with me on this journey, and happy reading, everyone.
Wish I was a sailor, I'd float away. I'd take you on a trip, take you far away. Holes in your shoes, but you don't care. You're a rock and roll minstrel. We're not kids, no, we're not kids anymore. The leaves are turning.